हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू जीके टुडे। दिस इज नुजहत सना एंड इन टुडेज वीडियो विल बी डूइंग द करंट अफेयर्स फॉर 29th ऑफ अगस्त 2024। दीज आर सम ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स और कीवर्ड्स दैट वी वुड बी कवरिंग इन टुडेज सेशन। फॉर एग्जांपल, वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट द मरुहबा कप, देन देर इज एशियन सर्फिंग चैंपियनशिप्स, देन देर इज द लोकेशन ऑफ विरूपक्ष टेम्पल, देन विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट द शोम्पेन ट्राइब, आफ्टर दैट विल टॉक अबाउट इंडियन नेवल शिप मुंबई, देन तावा रिजर्वॉयर विच हैज बीन रिसेंटली डिक्लेयर्ड एज रामसर साइट, देन विल बी सीइंग द यूनिफाइड पेंशन स्कीम एंड वुलर लेक। ओके, सो नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द सेशन विदाउट एनी फर्दर डिले। द वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज, विच कंट्री सिक्योर द सिल्वर मेडल एट द मरुहबा कप, which is a team event at the Asian Surfing Championships 2024. Correct answer here is B option, India. Okay, India won a silver medal at the Maruhaba Cup in the Asian Surfing Championships 2024, the venue of which was Maldives. It took place in Maldives, and the Indian team included some players like Kamali P, Ajish Ali, Shrikant D and Sanjay Sail Vamani, and Japan won the gold with 58.4 points. And India was placed at second position with 24.13 points. Taipei country won the bronze with 23.93 points, and China came at fourth with 22.1 points. Okay. Also, India won the Heat 2 semi finals, scoring 32.16 point, and the win follows India's first ever surfing quota for the Asian Games. The Indian surfer Harish Muthu also reached the quarterfinals, making history for India. Okay, so here correct answer is B option, India. Three questions you can be asked. The first one is, what is the venue of Asian Surfing Championship? It took place in Maldives. The second question you can be asked is, which country was the winner in this, means which country has won the gold? So this is the country Japan. And what was India's rank in this championship? India was placed at second position with silver medal. Okay, now talking about the Asian Surfing Championships, first of all, which country has won the most medals in the history of Asian Surfing Championships? This is the country Japan. Okay, now talking about Maldives, what is the capital city of Maldives? We know it. Answer is Male. Which ocean are the Maldives situated in? So it is situated in Indian Ocean. And what is the official religion of the Maldives? So their official religion is Islam. Fine. And talking about the Asian Games, first time Asian Games were held in 1951, and Asian Games are repeated after every 4 years. Fine. Moving to the next question, Virupaksh Temple recently seen in the news is located in which Indian state? Correct answer here is C option, Karnataka. Virupaksh Temple lies in Hampi, Karnataka. And why it came into news? Because recently a temple pavilion has been collapsed due to heavy rains in 2024. Okay, so now concerns have been raised about the conservation of this UNESCO World Heritage Site. This temple is dedicated to Lord Virupaksh, which is another form of Lord Shiva. It is located in Hampi, Vijayanagar district in the state of Karnataka. And this site has been a UNESCO World Heritage Site since 1986. Okay, so temple has been in continuous use since the 7th century AD, making it one of the India's oldest functioning temples, and later it was expanded during the Vijayanagar, Chalukyan and Hoysala periods. Okay, so the location of Virupaksh temple is the state of Karnataka. Talking about the Virupaksh temple, it originated in 7th century AD first of all. Then who is the primary deity that is worshipped in Virupaksh temple? So it is dedicated to Lord Virupaksh, which is another form of Shiva. Fine. Then talking about UNESCO World Heritage Sites in India, which is the first Indian site to be inscribed as a UNESCO World Heritage Site? This is the Ajanta Caves. Okay. Then which organization administers the UNESCO World Heritage Site? Obviously, it is UNESCO. The full form is United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization. Now coming to the next question, Shumpen tribe of people which were seen in the news are located in which state or the Union Territory? Correct answer here is D option, Andaman and Nicobar Islands. So Union Environment Minister has assured that developing a port and airport in the Nicobar Islands will not disturb the Shompen tribe in any means. And the Shompen tribe is one of the most isolated and the least studied tribes of India. And also it is considered as PVTG, means particularly vulnerable tribal group. Okay. So they live in dense rainforest of Great Nicobar Island, which is 95% percent rainforest and also a biological hotspot. Their habitat includes the Campbell Bay National Park, Galathea National Park, for example, and the Great Nicobar Biosphere Reserve. So the 2011 census estimated their population to be 229, but the exact number is still unknown. They are semi-nomadic hunter-gatherers and they rely on hunting, fishing and basic horticulture. Shompen tribe lives in small groups near the rivers and they set up their temporary camps in the forest. Okay, so Shompen tribe of people are located in the Union Territory of Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Now, talking about the Nicobar Islands, which is the southernmost point of land in the territory of India, which is located on this island, correct answer is Indra Point. And name the expansive biosphere reserve in the Nicobar Islands, which is recognized for its unique biodiversity. This is the Great Nicobar Biosphere Reserve. Talking about the Shompen tribe, the Shompen tribe is native to which island group in India? It lies in Great Nicobar Islands, and their population is approximately 229 in as per the 2011 census. But yes, their population is still unknown. Their real population is still unknown. Then what type of subsistence strategy do the Shompen tribes employ? Means what type of practice they follow? So they are semi-nomadic hunter-gatherers. Fine. Talking about the Campbell Bay National Park, in which year was this national park established? It was established in 1992. It lies in which island? It lies in Great Nicobar Island. And Campbell Bay National Park is a part of which large ecological reserve? So this is Great Nicobar Biosphere Reserve. Fine. Now coming to the next question. Which Indian naval ship recently arrived at the port of Colombo for a 3-day maiden visit to the country Sri Lanka? This is INS Mumbai. INS Mumbai is a Delhi class guided missile destroyer, and recently it made its maiden visit to Colombo, Sri Lanka for 3 days. And the ship was commissioned into the Indian Navy on January 22 in the year 2001 and built at Mezagon Dockyards Limited in Mumbai. It has been recognized as the best ship 3 times. Also, it has been awarded the most spirited ship award 2 times. Okay. So INS Mumbai has played key roles in different operations like Operation Parakram, Operation Sukoon, then there is Operation Rahat. Okay. So it underwent a mid-life upgrade and joined the Eastern Naval Command in Visakhapatnam in the year 2023. So INS Mumbai has arrived at the port of Colombo for a 3-day maiden visit to the country Sri Lanka. What questions you can be asked about INS Mumbai? First of all, you can be asked that INS Mumbai was commissioned into the Indian Navy in which year? So this is the year 2001. Which shipyard built INS Mumbai? This is Mezagon Dockyards Limited. And during which operation did INS Mumbai assist in the evacuation from Lebanon? Already we have talked about it. This ship has participated in different operations like Operation Parakram, Operation Sukoon and Operation Rahat. Okay. Talking about Mezagon Dockyards Limited, where is the Mezagon Dockyards Limited located? So it lies in Mumbai. When was this body established? So it was established in 1774. And which famous submarine series was built by Mezagon Dockyards Limited? It is very famous, Scorpion class submarine. Fine. Then what is the headquarters of Eastern Naval Command? The headquarter lies in Visakhapatnam, and Eastern Naval Command was established in the year 1968. Fine. Coming to the question number 5. Tawa Reservoir, recently seen in the news, is located in which Indian state? So this reservoir lies in the state of Madhya Pradesh. And why it came into news? Because recently it has been designated as a new Ramsar site along with 2 more bird sanctuaries, which are these Nanjarayan Bird Sanctuary and Kazuveli Bird Sanctuary. Both of these bird sanctuaries lies in Tamil Nadu. Okay. So it is located at the confluence of the Tawa and the Denwa rivers near Itarsi, and it was originally built for irrigation and now also it supports power generation and aquaculture. So it is within the Satpura Tiger Reserve, bordering the Satpura National Park and Bohri Wildlife Sanctuary. And major tributaries are, for example, River Malani, then there is Nagdwari and Sonabhadra. Okay. So Tawa River is the longest tributary of Narmada River. Don't forget it. Okay. And it starts in the Mahadev Hills, then it flows through the kind of Betel and it joins the Narmada in Narmadapuram, and this reservoir is home to spotted deer and painted stork. Okay, so you simply have to remember the location of Tawa Reservoir. It lies in the state of Madhya Pradesh. Why it came into news? Because recently it has been designated as a new Ramsar site along with 2 bird sanctuaries that lie in Tamil Nadu. Okay, talking about Tawa Reservoir, what year was the Tawa Reservoir completed? So it was formed in 1974. And what is the primary purpose of this reservoir? So primary purpose is irrigation. Then coming to Ramsar site, What year was the Ramsar Convention signed? It was signed in 1971. Which country has the highest number of Ramsar site? This is UK. And if we talk about the Satpura Tiger Reserve, in which year was the Satpura Tiger Reserve established? It was established in 1981. Then what is the state animal which is protected within the Satpura Tiger Reserve? It is the Indian giant squirrel. Talking about the Narmada River, which waterfall is located on the Narmada River? It is the Dhuandhar Falls. Fine. And in which state does the Narmada River primarily flow? So it flows in Madhya Pradesh. Coming to the next question. Recently, how many new districts have been announced for the Union Territory of Ladakh by the Union Home Minister? The correct answer here is 5. C option is the correct answer. Union Home Minister Amit Shah has announced the creation of 5 new districts in Ladakh, and these are named as Zanskar. Then there is Dras, Sham, Nubra and Changtheng. Okay, you have to remember the names of all these districts. And the decision aims to improve the governance and bring benefits closer to the people. Ladakh has only 2 districts earlier. These are Leh and Kargil. Since it is large and sparsely populated, so now the new districts will help in implementing the public welfare schemes more effectively. And the Ministry of Home Affairs has asked the Ladakh administration to form a committee to plan the new districts, including the details like headquarters and boundaries. And they have to submit this report within next 3 months. Okay. So 5 new districts have been proposed by the Union Home Minister for the Union Territory of Ladakh, and their names are very, very important. Okay. Now, what 2 districts existed in Ladakh before the creation of the new ones? So these are only 2 districts, Leh and Kargil. Okay. And in which year Ladakh became a separate Union Territory? It became a separate Union Territory in 2019. And which mountain range passes through Ladakh? These are the Himalayas. Now, which is the smallest Union Territory of India by area? This is the Lakshadweep Islands. And talking about the schemes, which scheme aims to provide LPG connection to the women who are from below poverty line families? This is the Pradhan Mantri Ujwala Yojana. And which initiative aims to provide insurance coverage to the poorer sections in India? This is Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana. And what is the objective of the Swachh Bharat mission? Basic objective is to eliminate the open defecation and improve the waste management, right? Coming to the next question. Which state has recently become the first to implement the Unified Pension Scheme, UPS? Correct answer here is A option, Maharashtra. Maharashtra became the first state to adopt the UPS for its employees ahead of assembly elections. And the UPS was introduced by the central government on 24th of August 2024. It basically replaces the 21-year-old National Pension System, NPS. Okay, and it is similar to the old pension scheme. So this change effectively reverses the pension reforms which are implemented by the Atal Bihari Vajpayee government. Okay, so Maharashtra state is the first to implement the Unified Pension Scheme. Talking about Maharashtra, what is the capital city? Correct answer is Mumbai. Also, I have told you already that Mumbai is the entertainment city of India as well. Okay, which famous national park is located in Maharashtra? It is the Sanjay Gandhi National Park. Which UNESCO World Heritage Site is situated in Maharashtra and it is known for its rock cut caves? These are the Ajanta caves. Okay. Talking about the Unified Pension Scheme, first of all, it was introduced in 2024. And which state is the first to adopt this UPS? Obviously, it is Maharashtra. And which old pension scheme is similar to UPS? It is the old pension scheme. Now, if we talk about the NPS, means National Pension Scheme. First of all, when was the National Pension System implemented in India? It was implemented in 2003. And which organization regulates the National Pension System in India? This is PFRDA, means Pension Fund Regulatory and Development Authority. And which type of pension scheme did the NPS replace? So it has replaced the Defined Benefit Pension Scheme. Okay. Coming to the next question. Wooler Lake, recently seen in the news, is located in which state or the union territory? So Wooler Lake lies in Jammu and Kashmir. Wooler Lake is gradually being filled with silt from streams flowing in from surrounding mountains. It is basically the largest freshwater lake in India. Also, it is the second largest in Asia. Okay, and it is located in Jammu and Kashmir's Bandipur district. Basically, it is fed by the Jhelum River and it has an altitude of 1580 meters near the Haramukh mountain, and it is formed by the tectonic activity and a remnant of the ancient Satisar lake. Okay, it features a central island named as Zainalank, which is built by King Zainul Abidin. Okay, so it was designated as a new Ramsar wetland in 1990, and it supports a diverse bird species, and it is very important for fish production in the state as well. Okay, so you simply have to remember the location of Wooler Lake. It lies in Jammu and Kashmir. Now, what questions can be framed regarding Wooler Lake? First of all, in which districts is Wooler Lake located? So it lies in Bandipur in the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir. Then regarding Jhelum River, you can be asked that Jhelum River is a tributary of which major river system? So it is a tributary of the Indus River system. Okay, and in which year Wooler Lake was designated a Ramsar wetland? So it was designated as a Ramsar wetland in 1990. What is the purpose of Ramsar Convention? So basic purpose is the preservation of wetlands of international importance. Which country has the most number of Ramsar sites? This is the country UK. Fine. Coming to the next question. Atacama Salt Flat, recently seen in the news, is the largest salt deposit in which country? Correct answer here is B option, Chile. Okay. So researchers from the University of Chile found that Chile's Atacama Salt Flat is sinking due to lithium brine extraction. Okay. So Atacama Salt Flat is the largest salt deposit in Chile, and it features a white surface with a large salt lake beneath it. The lake under the salt flat holds one of the world's largest lithium reserves, and it is located in the Atacama Desert, which is one of the driest places on the earth. Also, it is the northest part of the basin, which includes the San Pedro River Delta. Okay, so Atacama Salt Flat is the largest salt deposit in the country Chile. Talking about Atacama Desert, which capital city lies closest to the Atacama Desert? This is Lima. And Lima is the capital of which country? It is the capital of Peru. Okay. Now, which country is the largest producer of lithium? This is the country Australia. And which is the world's largest river delta? This is the Ganga Brahmaputra Delta. Okay. Coming to the last question. Recently, India signed the Security of Supplies Arrangement Agreement along with which country? Correct answer here is US. Okay. So, India and US have signed two key defense agreements. The first one is SOSA, means the Securities of Supplies Arrangement Agreement, and a Memorandum of Understanding on Liaison Officers. Okay, why to boost the defense cooperation? So SOSA aims to enhance the industry collaboration by ensuring the priority support for defense goods and services between the two nations. And under SOSA, both countries can request the faster delivery for defense contracts from each other's companies. Okay, so it would help them in managing supply chain issues, and also US will offer India assurances through its defense priorities and allocation system, while India will set up a code of conduct for prioritizing US defense needs. So with this, India is now the 18th country to sign the SOSA with the US, joining nations like Australia, Israel, Japan and the UK. Fine. So India has signed the Security of Supplies Arrangement Agreement along with the country US, and with this India is the 18th number of country to sign it. Fine. Now, which country was the first country to sign the Security of Supplies Arrangement with US? This was the country Canada. And under this system and under this arrangement, which system does the US use to prioritize the defense need? So defense priorities and allocation system is basically used. And how many countries had signed SOSA with the US before India? These are the 17 countries. So in total, now 18 countries have signed the SOSA. Fine. So these are the most important current affairs for today. And now we'll move to our revision part, in which today we'll be revising which three topics? The first one would be business, economy and banking current affairs. The second would be defense current affairs. And the third would be reports and indices. Fine. So first of all, let's move to business, economy and banking current affairs MCQs, where the first question is, Samoa pathway is associated with which one of the following groupings? So this pathway is related to Small Island Developing States, SIDS. Okay. What is tax incidence recently mentioned in the news? So tax incidence is basically the division of tax burden between the stakeholders. Recently, which country has become India's second largest liquefied natural gas supplier? So now the country US has become India's second largest LNG supplier. Which organization is currently running a pilot program for the unified lending interface? This is the Reserve Bank of India. Prava portal is launched by which institution? Again, same answer. Answer is Reserve Bank of India. What is the primary objective of CDP Suraksha platform recently mentioned in the news? So primary purpose of CDP Suraksha platform is to disburse the subsidies to horticultural farmers. Recently, where was the Agriculture Integrated Command and Control Center inaugurated? The center was inaugurated in New Delhi. Fine. Coming to the second slide, which is about the defense current affairs. Recently, which organization has successfully completed 6 consecutive development trials of high-speed expendable aerial target HEAT means Abhyas? This is the DRDO. INS Sunaina belongs to which type of class? INS Sunaina is a Seru class submarine. Which naval ship was recently decommissioned after 38 years of service to the Indian Navy? This is INS Nirupak. It has been decommissioned in the month of January after providing 38 years of its service to the Indian Navy. INS Jatayu, which has recently been in the news, is the Indian naval base located in which region? It lies in Lakshadweep Islands. Rudram 2 air-to-surface missile is developed by which organization? Correct answer here is DRDO. Maritime partnership exercise was conducted between which two countries? It was conducted between Russia and India. According to the SIPRI report, how many nuclear warheads does India currently have? As per the SIPRI report, India have currently 172 nuclear warheads. Now, the third topic would be our reports and indices, where the first question is, what is the rank of India in the World Economic Forum's Travel and Tourism Development Index 2024? First of all, you have to remember that Travel and Tourism in Development Index is released by the World Economic Forum, and the headquarters of World Economic Forum lies in Davos, Switzerland. Correct answer here is 39. Recently, which organization released the report titled as Asia and the Pacific SDG Progress Report 2024? This report has been published by UNESCAP. Economic and Social Survey of Asia and the Pacific 2024 report recently released by which organization? This report has been published by UNESCAP again, United Nations Economic and Social Commission for Asia and the Pacific. Recently, which organization launched a report titled as The Case for Investment in Nutritious Food Value Chain? This report was published in the month of August, and here correct answer is Global Alliance for Improved Nutrition. What is the trend of cybercrimes and economic offences in 2022 as compared to 2021? Obviously, it has been increased. Which organisation recently published a first national report on AMR surveillance in India's fisheries, livestock sectors for 2019 to 2022? This is Food and Agriculture Organisation, which is the body of United Nations and headquartered lies in Rome, Italy. India Gaming Report 2024 was released by which organization? This report was published by Interactive Entertainment and Innovation Council and WINSO. Okay. So this is all about the today's session. I hope you have liked it. And now I'm giving you some questions as a homework. And the homework today would be related to environment and biodiversity related current affairs. So please carefully read all of the questions that are given in the slide and try to answer as much as you can. I'll be waiting for your answers. And before concluding, let me tell you that these questions are part of our daily 20 MCQ series on GK Today Android application. So if you want the PDF of the lecture, you can subscribe to that course. Now we'll be meeting tomorrow with some more important current affairs. Till then, stay tuned. Thank you so much for watching. And please do not forget to subscribe to GK Today. With this, Meenu Zahid Sana signing off.